Today we're going to Ocala to try to answer a question. Lots of times we see stuff for sale or advertised on eBay or Amazon or something like that, and we wonder if this stuff is any good. Is this stuff any good? So I'm going to try something today. I want to get a baseline on the Z06 to find out what my rear wheel horsepower is, and then I'm going to make one small change and see if that small change works. And what I'm looking at here is I'm looking at this sheet here, and it's from eBay. I bought this. It's an air cleaner made by Berger, who are pretty well known. They got a great rating of 99.8% positive feedback. So pretty good. And what we're going to do is we're going to dyno the Z06, and then we're going to put this air filter in and dyno it again. Now they're telling us we're going to get up to, oh, I don't know, 30, what's it say here, up to 30 rear wheel horsepower. There we go, up to 30. So maybe we'll get it, maybe we won't, but we're going to find out today. And by the way, they make these air cleaners for just about every C7. There's a list here on the sheet, so it looks like they've covered every C7 from the very first one, 2015 on, 14 on, whatever it was. Anyway, so we're going to take this box and we're going to head out, and we're going to get into the Z06 and take a ride over to Ocala to Burns, which is a kind of a hot rod place. And so we're going to go over there and have them put this thing on. Well, first of all, we're going to dyno the car, then put this thing on and dyno the car again, and we'll see what we got. So off we go to Burns's over in Ocala. Great bunch of people. We'll show you more about it as the video goes along here. Well, when you enter Burns's, this is what you see. Wonderful operation. Classic cars, loaded with beautiful classic cars. Beautiful automobiles all over the place. We're gonna go in here and look at a few things. Okay, open the front door. Speed shop, detailing, restoration, all kinds of things. Hey. I understand the man with all the knowledge is sitting right in front of
all
me.
All the knowledge.
All the knowledge. You are?
Jeffrey.
Jeffrey.
Yes.
And
AKA
Jeffrey's going to.
AKA Hollywood.
Hollywood. All right, we'll call you Hollywood.
Okay.
Hollywood, we're going to take a tour of this wonderful facility here.
Yeah.
And you just take me wherever you want to go.
We do all the frame off restorations.
Wow. Look at this.
On the classics, on the modern muscle cars, we do the supercharging with our Dyno lab right over here.
Yep.
Right there, we're dynoing them today. Our dyno tuners here on Tuesdays and Thursdays.
Yep.
And then, of course, last but not least, our showroom of 55 classics.
Wow.
And they're all online. You can visit us at bernies.com and see our inventory. Click on financing. Where I'm here full time now for 7 months. We're selling about 2 a week and getting 2 new ones in a week, every week.
Wow.
And we're pricing them to sell.
It's a candy store.
That's it.
It's not a car, it's a candy store. I love all the different varieties you have here. It's not like, you know, you're,
right.
It's you're very, a one-trick pony. You've very, got all the ponies in here.
Very diverse. We got the Ford, Mustang, Cougar, new and old. Corvettes, Chevelles, the Camaro, of course, is very popular. We can't keep them on the shelves, but we happen to have one left, the 69 one-year color combination. Nice car.
Yep. Beautiful.
Trucks. This is one of my favorites, the 67 Cougar. It's an original owner car. Isn't that fabulous?
Wow.
Look 289.
My goodness.
Got about 100,000 miles.
Paint's beautiful on
original
it.
On the chassis.
Wow. A beautiful car.
We got some race cars. It's a Hemi.
Oh, yeah.
528.
Jeez, look at that, huh?
And we've got trucks.
You even got an MG.
Classic, yeah, that's a 1951 MG TD. Quite a nice little collector piece. 48
wow.
Merc, yes, last year of that model before they went with the shoebox
yeah.
body. NSX there, a Honda, you know, you got your Fieros, Grand National,
wow.
on down to our selection of Jeeps. We always got to keep a couple Jeeps on stock because, you know, we are in Jeep country.
Yeah,
with the
exactly.
North Central Florida thing. And we get some pretty unique pieces. They are unique, I got to say.
Yeah.
All restored, typically, with new motors and suspension, you know. This
oh,
is a, kind of like a collector piece of old Ram Land Rover.
Wow.
You know, renovated 1980, you know, CJ8, a 95 YJ, you know, very nice.
Yep.
Volkswagen bus.
I love that.
Yeah. And then the Mopar collection, of course, that's really some of the most popular
beautiful.
Stuff.
Beautiful. Look at that. Absolutely gorgeous.
And then, you know, the classic Keybird.
Wow.
You can kind of shoot back this away, you know, for those big, we call them big fender cars, you know.
Yeah.
Which are exotic, you know. Higher end, 60, 50, 60, 70,000 dollar cars. But I mean, that's the value of them. I mean, it's not a inflated estimate. Their values are true.
Beautiful. This one here is beautiful.
Yeah, it's a Wild Rod, which is a
wow,
very
look
high
at the,
end.
I mean, I gotta get a shot of the paint here. I mean,
fiberglass.
Wow.
You know, it's a fiberglass body, but it's a very world renowned builder.
Wow, that's
a $70,000 car all day
yeah.
long. It is
yeah.
nice car.
Yeah, and it's beautiful too.
Yeah,
very nice.
And a nice Dart. We just, you know, the T-bucket. I mean, just what a wide variety.
That's the best variety I've seen.
You
anywhere.
Know,
they really
we're
have
pricing
a great
that
variety.
At 19, on our showroom, brand new on our showroom, just built by a local builder. Price point on our showroom at $19,000.
Wow.
You couldn't build it for that.
No, you couldn't. You could not. Absolutely. Hollywood, you're the best. That was great. Thank you so much,
Thank
man.
Thank you
that
very
was really
much
great.
For coming.
And come on down to Burns.
Come on down.
And look at these beautiful cows. And if you want, he might even sell you one if you're really nice.
That's it.
I love this tea bucket. This is nice, too.
Yes, this is... Yes, this is my favorite, honestly.
That thing is beautiful. Look at this, huh?
Yeah.
Pretty car. Lot of nice inventory. I mean, beautiful inventory.
Thank you.
Beautiful inventory. Okay, we're at Bernie's. And Bernie's is located in Ocala.
One Aspen Road. Ocala, Florida.
What's the name of this road out here? This is called the...
Baseline. Or Route 35.
So you're north of Ocala. Well,
Bellevue. 4 miles north of Bellevue.
Okay.
And about 7.5 miles south of 40. Silver Springs Boulevard.
Very good. Thanks so much, Hollywood. Yep. Appreciate it. That was
Thank
great.
Thank you so much for stopping by.
All right. You're welcome. Okay, so now we're taking out the old filter. Tony, my man, is taking out the old filter. There it is right there. And we're replacing it with this little beauty right here. Then we're going to do another dyno run. And we'll see the comparison to see if we pick up any horsepower. So we're looking at the sheet here with all the data. I'm going to put it up on the screen so you can see it. Follow me along. Stock horsepower, the best number we got was 546. Rear wheel horsepower, 553. Rear wheel torque. If you multiply that times 1.2 to get the flywheel horsepower, it's a 20% drivetrain loss, you can get And when we did that to both of those numbers, we get 655 and 663. Now, Corvette advertises the Z06 650 horsepower, 650 foot-pounds of torque, so I'm at 655 and 663. That's pretty good. Then we put the filter, took the best number on the filter, which was 555, rear wheel horsepower, 610 on torque. That's at the rear wheels. Multiplied that by 1.2 to factor in the drivetrain loss. End up with 666 horsepower. That's with the filter, the best run. And 732 foot-pounds of torque. Now, if I subtract the with the filter number, and the stock number, which I did on the bottom section, 666 minus 655 and 732 minus 663, I end up with a net gain of 11 horsepower and 69 foot-pounds of torque. That is pretty good. So there you have it. Those are the numbers. I like the numbers, but what does it drive like? The next thing, these numbers don't mean crap if you don't go out and drive the car and see how it feels. So I had about a half an hour ride coming back. The gas pedal feels a lot more responsive. The car feels a tight quicker. I don't know if that's a mind game. It's, you know, I put in the new filter, I'm expecting. But I'll tell you, in all honesty, but seat of my pants, it feels better. It feels quicker. Am I happy with it? Yes. Would I buy it again? Yes. Okay. Also, I want to thank the people down at Bernie's, down in Ocala, for doing the Dyno. I paid for it, but I mean, they did it. They did a nice job. I would also recommend the people down at Bernie's if you're looking for any kind of a car. Go down and look at the stock. They're very nice. Drop in and kick tires all you want. They do a lot of performance work. If you want a supercharger, you want to do something to your engine, they do all that stuff. They're very, very good. And the guy that owns it, an alcohol dragster guy who goes all over the country, check him out too. So a lot of fun. We had a good day, and I hope this is helpful. If you're first time on here, please hit the subscribe button. And if you like the video, hit the like button. We need those clicks. They really help us, and it encourages us to keep doing videos like this again, and we get some more things in the pipeline coming up soon. So thanks again, and thanks for watching.